person sitting here today is craving for a healthy body. With many actors carrying six packs, it's just been an era of fashion and physique. Beauty with brains, beauty or brains, fat or slim, trendy or a decent kind of look, it's just all in you to take it in the right spirit and come up with the best attitude possible. Mr. Cottage Chair, fellow Toastmasters, when I was 5'10", I used to weigh around 96 kilos with a waist size of 36 inches. People used to call me by different names. Hey, Dumma, Fat Pig, Kumbhakarna, and what not. Today, I'm 6 foot Jane. And my journey from 36 to 30 has been all inspired by one great personality, Hrithik Roshan. Yes, Hrithik Roshan. When asked in an interview as what you got to do to stay fit and get a better physique, he said, I did not tell anything much to you guys. You know why? Because you people know what to do and what not to. You know what's right and what's wrong. It's just that people are way too lazy. Overcoming this particular laziness, I'm standing here in front of you. And I believe that I have achieved this Herculean task. Look at Adnan Sami today. It feels as if a great human being in himself has been lost. He's lost that much of weight. It feels a great change from a watermelon to a muskmelon. If you're actually wondering how could one turn into a cute pumpkin like me as I was before, let me tell you, death by chocolate and ice cream in the corner versus absolutely irresistible. Loads of kachoris, loads of samosas, loads of chocolate mousse, and loads of extra cheese. And what about those sweets? My God, gajar ka halwa, gulab jamun, rasgulla. Too tempting, right? I'm just mentioning them right now, but imagine eating all those things. It used to be really difficult for me to get up early in the morning at 5:30 and go for a jog. But the willpower and the determination in me made me to reduce weight. Yes. If you're actually thinking, you know, in a sense that why people turn into a cute pumpkin, as I've already told before about the death by chocolate and everything. Yes, people do a lot of sweets and everything, but have you thought about the consequences? The diseases? Let me tell you. Coronary heart disease. A disease wherein a person's heart gets weak. Type 2 kind of diabetes. 80% of the people suffer from that particular diabetes because of excessive sweets. Cancer, which will reduce your lifespan. And sleep apnea, a disease wherein a person stops breathing for short intervals when he sleeps. One of my friends was suffering from anorexia. A disease wherein people think that they will go fat and they'll stop eating. I had to take him to the doctor, take him to the dietitian. Now he's fine. It was an absolute shock for me at that point of time. But today I have realized the fact that I need to eat to live and not live to eat. Yes, we need to eat sweets. Yes, we need to enjoy our life. We need to eat all kind of things, but we need to know where to draw lines. Definitely, we need to know. If you're actually thinking about what will happen to me later, what's going to happen right now, what's happening right now, let me tell you one second, just don't think about it. Go ahead. If you're thinking, what can be done, let me tell you. If you want to reduce and stay fit, yes, let me tell you what to do for that. You can just go and stand next to a fat person and claim that you're no more fat. Jokes apart. But being frank, you can get up early in the morning at 5:30 or even 5 or 6 o'clock. Get up with a great smile on your face. Get up and go for a jog. Go for a jog. Go for a jog with your dog. If you don't have a dog, doesn't matter, but go for a jog. Because the fresh air what you get at that point of time wouldn't be available the rest of the day. Is it not? Eat healthy food. Don't eat junk food. Eat at regular intervals, but don't hog. Eat vegetables, fruits, drink loads of milk and water. Swim, exercise, play outdoor games. Dance like me. I mean, not like me, but dance. Dance. Play outdoor games. Doesn't matter, but play. Play a lot of games. But most importantly, what I think is, nothing is impossible in this world. And we need to realize that we need to have this burning desire in ourselves, not to live just for ourselves, but even for our family there. So Toastmasters, let's have a dream today. Let's have a dream to reduce. When you get up early in the morning, you'll be left with just two options then. The first one says, I want to go back and sleep. The second one says, no, I have to go for the job. The choice is all yours, Toastmasters. All yours. Condescend.